Good morning, sports card fans. Beantown 62 coming at you live from Abilene, Texas, where it is a monumentous day because it is the Beantown 62's birthday. That's it. Man, sound the alarm, send the confetti in the air. Beantown 62 strikes his birthday on February 23rd, 2020. And how old does that make Beantown? Dang old. Dang old. Well, yesterday we were down in Seguin, Texas, watching my daughter, the defending national champions, play some softball. And they gutted out a 5-0 win and an 8-0 win in 6 innings. And the Texas Lutheran shortstop takes her batting average to 500 this weekend, has the prestigious honor of leading the team in RBIs and sacrifices from the 9-hole in the batting order. You tell me. I don't know. It's crazy, but it all works. What part of defending national champions don't we understand, right? I don't know. I've been doing this all wrong my whole life, I guess. But anyways, we had us a little break. We got a birthday gift from the Sports Card Fam, and we busted that open while we were in Seguin. Here's a clip of some of the action, and we'll be right back with you to show the hits. Yeah. Good evening, Sports Card fans. Beantown 62 coming at you live from the power plant in Seguin, Texas. Not in Abilene tonight because we're down in Seguin watching my daughter crush a team from Washington State in 2 games, and we're here for Beantown's birthday. And so with that, somebody named the Sports Card Fam got him this really nice box of 2013 Museum Collection. And in this box, we got autographs, we got autograph relics, we got jumbo relics and quad relics. What could else we have? Somebody told me we could have something else that we're not going to say because we're probably going to get it anyways. But let's open up this box and see what we get for our birthday. What is going on here? What is he doing? He's shooting YouTube videos. So we have Kirk Nizanowski? 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 Can anybody help me out with this?
It is a redemption.
Juan Please. Carlos.
Ooh, that was a nice to 50.
Nice to 50. I know that's
Please
going.
Tell me the redemption is not a good player.
All right, here we are. And I mean, crazy, crazy stuff, right? I mean, here we are breaking some 2013 Topps Museum Collection. Museum Collection. And the first numbered card we pulled was just wicked good, wicked nice, to 199. I'm going to use my other hand. I've got a shadow if I go that way. Why not go this way? Look at that, to 199, green, Felix Hernandez. Believe he just retired. And so there you go. And our second numbered card, shout out to the Cuban Collector down in Miami, where I am sure Jonathan is live in Miami. Look at this beautiful, beautiful Juan Carlos Stanton. I guess you'd say green, but it's turquoise to go with the fish, the fighting fish, numbered 250. And that's awesome. Awesome hit. I got a pile of cards that are probably heading somebody's way, and that'll probably get added in. And our quad relic, the pack, of course, comes with a quad relic. Bam! Look at that. Huh? 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 It's 99. Joey Votto. Hey! I'm probably not saying that right. Hey, Votto! I'd have to call up my friends in L.A. Papino man. Am I saying Votto right? I don't know. But I think they're 4 of the exact same pieces of material. Got a little bit of a lump up here. Maybe he didn't iron it before they put it in there. I don't know. But cool. Cool. I kind of know who would like that. There's probably somebody out there, maybe, that would like that card. And then we have, of course, another relic, and we had ourselves a Boston hit. we have the Bocard. Boom. Look at that, huh? Look at that. We got us the dang boat. Billy Buckner, 15. I think it says 15 or 20. Yep. 25. What is the number? 20, 25, 22. I can't tell. I think it's 20. So it's 15 and 20. Yeah, it's 20. So we got us this big giant bat swat of Bill Buckner. That is awesome, isn't it? So awesome to get that. How many Buckner hits do you get in cards? First one I've ever seen. And then we go to our autograph relic coming in at 5 of 5 for the Mets. Boom. Kirk Newenhaus. I think I'm saying that right. Me and Mrs. Beantown went round and round, but I think it's Newenhaus. Numbered 5 of 5. Tell me there's a Newenhaus collector out there. Somebody got to want this card, right? Right? Comment below and tell me what you'll give Beantown for this card. It'll be yours. Kirk Newenhaus, 5. A really pretty card. Really pretty card. I believe, got a nice little two-color. Not, you know, you'd think on a 5 of 5, they put a little better patch. But a little two-color napkin in there. And then, the creme de la creme of a 2013 Topps Museum Collection. What is the best thing you could possibly ever get in there? You guessed it! Boom! A redemption! A redemption that expired in 2016. Oh, I got to get this. What is it? Iwakuma redemption. Somebody tell. I'm going to put it. We got a petition, Tops. This is really another one. Here we go. Can we go on a rant? One of the biggest ripoff crocs there is in sports card trading are redemptions. Tops, if you can't get your cards together in time to put the product out, you should do one of two things. I paid you for that box that's supposed to have two autographs. You either give me the autograph or you give me my money back. Why don't you go out and collect all of the product that hasn't sold after 2016 and pull it back in instead of making people buy it and get nothing? Nothing. It should be illegal and it probably is. Maybe I should go find a lawyer. What do you think? Comment below. Should we find a lawyer? And there you go. That's the hits from the box. I did get some mail in, and we got us this really super cool boom. Number 1 of 25 Ultimate Signatures 2004 vintage. Huh, that date rings a bell. What could it be? You guessed it. World Series champions. Boston Red Sox, the Boston Red Sox. So, we break the curse of the Bambino in 2004, but was it really the curse of the Bambino? Interesting history fact for the Boston Red Sox. For all of you Red Sox fans out there, you may or may not know this. The Boston Red Sox were the very last team in the Major League Baseball to allow black players to come on to their Major League team. And the first black player for the Boston Red Sox was, who said it first? You're right. Pumpsie Green was the first black player to play for the Boston Red Sox. Now, here's the trivia in all of this. Can anyone out there tell me what players were in the Red Sox farm system that may have been a little bit of help to the team back then in the 50s, that may have, you know, again, a slow Red Sox team that had some sticks, who could have helped Ted Williams out there in the outfield that may have been a good combination that the Red Sox, because they wouldn't allow blacks to play, let get away and trade away and go away. Who could it be? You guessed it, Willie Mays. Willie Mays was in the Red Sox organization at that time when they did not allow blacks to play, and they traded him away because he wasn't going to come up to the big league club and play. Could you imagine if the Red Sox would have had Ted Williams and Willie Mays out in their outfield? Really? Speed? Power? Everything? Come on now. So, shame on the Yawkey family. Not a great story about the Red Sox, but it's truth, brother. It's truth. I'm glad we live in a kinder, gentler world where we have a half a brain and we can figure things out now. People are people. We're all the same. It don't matter, but it sure mattered in the 50s when we couldn't win and you have Ted Williams, one of the greatest hitters ever, and can't even win a championship with him. So there you go. Had you put Willie Mays out in the field, I'm guessing the Red Sox might have tipped the scales and maybe competed with the Yankees. What do you think? Comment out there. You know what? We're going to go out and do something today on our birthday. We appreciate the view. We're out of here. Later, dude.